Let's say you are designing a 4-layer PCB. You go to JLC PCB website and there are 14 different types of 4-layer PCBs. 14 different types. Which one you choose for your project? Is this PCB better or this one is better? When you have a closer look, the difference is in materials and in thickness of each layer. This kind of PCB specification is called PCB stackup. So this here is a PCB stackup. Stackup tells PCB manufacturer how they are going to build your PCB. For example, it tells them what materials they need to use, what is the thickness of each material, or how they are ordered. But now you may be thinking, PCB is super thin anyway. If we use different materials and different thickness of each layer, is it really going to make any difference? Is it really important? In many designs, stackup is very important. For most of the standard PCBs up to 2.5 GHz, materials are not so critical, but distance between layers still can make a big difference. So, how do you choose which PCB stackup to use? Here are 3 points you may want to consider when selecting PCB stackup for your board. Point 1. Layer thickness versus crosstalk. First, why do you think thickness of layers may be important? When we have signals running through our PCB, they create fields. When we let these fields travel too far away, they can cause all the kind of problems. One of the most common problems is that these fields can create noise on other signals. This is called crosstalk. And the larger the fields are, more tracks they can influence. And one of the simplest ways how to keep these fields as small as possible is to bring reference plane close to the track with our signal. Now, what is reference plane? Very often a reference plane is a big solid ground plane placed as a neighbor layer to our signal layer. Okay, here is signal, this is big ground plane. It will be like this, like on layer 1 we would be routing our tracks, and on layer 2 we would only have one big solid ground plane. When we place this big reference plane, big ground plane, close under or above of our signal, we can make the fields around our tracks smaller. And closer the reference plane is, smaller the fields will be and less influence they will have on the other signals. So, if we have a closer look at these two stackups, and our tracks are routed on layer 1 and our ground plane or reference plane is on layer 2, which of these two stackups will be better? What do you think? I like this 3-3-1-3 stackup much more because our ground plane is closer to our signal layer. Point 2. Layer thickness versus track width. So another thing what you may want to consider when you are selecting stackup is track width. When you are designing your PCBs, how do you decide on what track width you are going to use? You know, how wide tracks you are going to draw on your PCB. Normally, you would like to use 50 ohm impedance for digital tracks. What does it mean? Based on your stackup, you can calculate what your track width should be. And larger the distance between the signal and reference layer is, wider and wider tracks we have to use. For example, if we use 4-layer PCB stackup, where our reference plane is 0.21 mm or 8 mm away, then we will have to use tracks which are 0.34 mm or 13 mm wide. However, if we use a PCB stackup where our reference plane is much closer, only 0.099 mm or 3.9 mm away, then we can use much smaller tracks. We can use tracks which are 0.15 millimeter wide or 6.16 mils. That is much smaller, and you can fit double of tracks into this same space. Point 3, what to consider. Layer count and order. Many people go from 2-layer PCB to 4-layer PCB only for one reason. Do you know which one? They don't have enough space to connect all the pins, all the signals. So they just go for 4-layer PCB and then they route signals everywhere, on every single layer. But think about it. We already mentioned to keep high quality signals on our PCB, we would like to have a solid reference plane close to our signal layer. So if we use this 3-3-1-3 stackup, how we may want to organize our PCB, do you know? For example, on layer 1, we can route our signals, but then on layer 2, we may want to have our ground reference plane. On layer 4, we can again route our signals, and we can use layer 3 as a reference plane for the signals routed on layer 4. That is the simplest 4-layer PCB stackup. Now, you may be like, but is not this waste of 4-layer PCB? Basically, we don't use layer 2 and layer 3 for routing. We are only using them for ground planes. But these two ground planes may save your circuit. Designing a reliable PCB, you know, a PCB which will work for years, continuously for years and for millions of people, is much more complicated than just connecting pins together. So you did not waste two layers, you made your PCB much better. Okay, don't worry. Of course, later, when you learn more about this topic, you can play with different stackups and reference planes. For example, you could make a solid ground plane on layer 4 and route signals on layer 3, or you could route some of the power planes on layer 2. But all these changes would be for another video, as there is much more explanation needed. If you are curious, I have created some videos on PCB stackup, so if you like, I highly recommend you to watch these. Especially if you would like to learn how to organize PCB stackup in more complicated boards with more layers. Now, the conclusion. If you are just starting with PCB, or you are still not sure what to use, this is what can be your starting point. Use 4-layer 3-3-1-3 PCB stackup. Use layer 1 and layer 4 to route signals and powers. Use layer 2 and layer 3 as a solid ground plane. Use 0.15 mm or 6.1 mm track width to route your signals. And we didn't speak about this, but place ground vias close to the places where your signals go between layer 1 and layer 4. These vias are called stitching vias, and I have done some videos on this topic, so if you would like to know why we need these vias and how they can help, check my other videos. If you would like to learn more about electronics, don't forget we have online courses about schematic design, PCB layout, EMC, measurements and more. Have a look at fedevil.com. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you found this video useful and see you next time. Bye!